Hello and welcome back to Season Stories, and we are continuing playing Alfred Hitchcock Vertigo. Last episode, well, we basically just set the mood and set the stage for the future. Yes, Ed Miller, the writer, lost his wife or girlfriend. It's in the description text, his wife, but I don't think he mentioned her as his wife, and her daughter, at least he's suspect. So also he saw his father jumping from the bridge and almost follow his imaginary father, and apparently he has some father issues, I'm guessing. And yeah, we managed to know something about Faye and very weird auntie. And now we are finally at the beach and we are relaxed before the afternoon session. Look for a good place outside, breathe and meditate, review session notes, have a lunch. Do I really want to eat that sandwich? And yeah, I noticed there are no sound. Music is on, FX is on, voice is on. I don't think we can do anything else except continue on. So I'm gonna take a little view of the area, so to speak, and see what I can find. There are some birds over there flocking. And I think, is that a swan? Swan or unicorn, I don't know. I'm guessing it's a swan. I took off anti-aliasing just to see if that helps with the stuttering. I think I read somewhere that people are suffering from occasional stuttering on this game. But I don't think tantalizing helped. I might see if I put it back. Let's see. Yeah, I don't see any difference at all. I mean, in the workings. Well, anyways, that's enough of that. We could go on the pier, or can I run? No. I probably could sit on the deck chair. But I do want to see if there's anything. Few books, nothing that I can actually check. And lots and lots of birds, sea fowls and whatnot. And there's nothing. Oh, there is something.
First, you have to pick a stone. This one? Julia, sweetie, that's the best skipping stone I have ever seen. Now, remember how to do it? Knees bent, hiney out, arms back, limp wrist, riding fingers, stone level with the ground. Eyes on the water, flick your wrist and the stone, skips! Flick your wrist and... Oh, that's okay. I'm sure next time will work out better.
Interesting. I'm curious what's the story behind our dear doctor here. Obviously, there are something also behind her, because yeah, she got the text message allegedly, probably from his husband or boyfriend, who said, I won't do that again, or something like that, if I remember correctly. And yeah, I guess there are some secrets also. And that is also hinted at the description of the game. Anyways, deck chair. Okay. It's still interesting that there's no music or sound effects at all. Hopefully they can come back at some point. Well, sandwich with therapy notes. Check message from Lou. Let's do that first. Lou, talk tonight if you're too busy tonight. Not yet. Okay, don't answer. Well, I don't want to go with the don't answer route, but okay. I call you when I'm free. Interesting tattoo behind the ear. So I think I will call. What are my objects? Review session notes, have a lunch. Let's call Robert, then maybe eat the sandwich, and then review the notes. Sounds like a plan.
The number you are trying to reach is currently unavailable.
Oh, poo. Okay. Do I even want to eat the sandwich? Is it poisoned? We had a lunch. So far, so good. At least we are alive at the moment. So let's review the notes.
Ed is reluctant and even hostile towards therapy. Why?
Mostly he's lying and he knows it. He's afraid of going crazy. He's keeping the truth from himself. Claire is manipulating him. Well, although I would like to go with Clarice manipulating him, but we really don't have any solid evidence of that. But the problem is he's lying, he knows it, and he's keeping the truth from himself. They are pretty much similar. He is lying something, almost certainly, but what he is lying and why he's lying, that's the question. He might be afraid to be going crazy. Maybe he's thinking that everybody else says they are not there, but he's certain they were there. I would go with that he's keeping the truth from himself.
He's blocking out a certain memory, one he doesn't want to remember, something too painful.
Well, I would go with several.
I've never seen such an intense case of vertigo before.
I'm guessing he's actually hiding several things, what happened with his parents and whatnot. Where did it go? It's real. He's like, well, the problem is, if we assume that he believes in it, whether it's real or not, and he is affected by it, it's of course then real for him at least. Although he might be lying that also, of course. I go with the it's real, but he's exaggerating.
He's not the first writer I've known to exaggerate his symptoms. To get attention, make people feel sorry for him, make it more realistic in his mind, which is so used to fiction. Does she exist?
About the exaggeration, I would rather go with the idea that he was actually making it as a defense mechanism so he doesn't have to confront the things he maybe don't want to remember. So I think, well, that was my idea, not that he's exaggerating just because he's a writer. Faye, that is a difficult question. So far, we only have our patient's word, a playboy's delusions. She might be a character from novel. Again, we don't have really a proof for that. Playboy's delusions. No, I would like to go with she exists. So far, there's really nothing that says she doesn't exist. Unless there is something it hasn't presented to us, but for now, I'm inclined to believe that she exists.
There are too many details, little things that somehow make sense. Faye exists, or existed. What about that earlier Vertigo episode? And his parents? Something happened in his childhood. But Claire isn't going to tell me. Maybe Robert? Or Ed himself, if I can break through this wall he's put up. I'll have to give it a try.
Okay.
Who am I speaking to?
Dr. Lomas?
Who is this?
It's Sheriff Reyes. Dr. Leonard gave me your number.
How are you, Sheriff?
Look, I don't want you to breach patient-doctor confidentiality or anything, but if something comes up in your conversations with Miller...
Is Ed under investigation? Is he the suspect of a crime?
No, not exactly.
If I understood correctly, Ed hasn't committed any crime.
Well, we'll have to see about that.
So, will you give me a hand?
I can't promise anything.
I'm not in a position to make any promises.
Mm-hmm. Well, I understand, Doctor. I would settle for anything at all.
That was weird. Change from with the sounds.
Maybe someone saw something. I'm on my way to his neighbors as we speak.
The Franklins?
Nick, you there?
Sorry, I've got to go. What is it this time, Adam?
Tell me you saw my email with the slogan proposals.
Yeah, great stuff, kid. I'm not sure which one I like the best.
I like the sixth one.
Yeah. That one was,
Vote for Sheriff Reyes, the sneaky bastard who would have known there were only three slogans if he'd read the...
Adam, do I have to tell your aunt and uncle you have no respect for your elders?
You at the ranch yet?
I'm on my way.
Look, if anyone asks, I was working on Saturday night, okay? I skipped the monthly dinner.
Hello, Samuel. Did you know your nephew is a sneaky bastard?
You wouldn't dare.
Hey, I'll check that out once I got a signal again, okay?
Okay. So we have a third character now. Well, this is ominous. Where's everybody? Talk to Samuel and Esther Franklin. No. Movement. Oh, finally I can run. Hold left trigger to make your character move faster. Okay. Well, it makes perfect sense that our dear doctor would want to run around. Places. Because why would you run if you don't need to? I'm gonna take a little look-see around the perimeter and see if I can find anything interesting. And there's just so a little micro stutter, and although I do enjoy the graphical aspects of this game, it's still a bit weird. Nothing that actually takes off the game, but anyways. Why is this telephone cable box? Interesting. Why it's open? Oh. Why are the cables ripped? Okay. Okay, why is it saving? okay. Why you didn't make... Well... It could have been a good idea to report, just in case. I want to see the barn first.
Samuel! Are you there? It's me, Sheriff Reyes.
Search the barn. Decisions. Do I want to search the barn first or go to the... Can I check the tractor? I can. Okay. Knight chess piece. Any particular reason? Maybe he likes chess. Chess is nice, although I suck in it. The barn is huge. Let's go to the barn first. I I wanted to go to the house first, but yeah, now I'm... Oh, it's... Okay. Starting to light up. And it's awfully quiet. Stable. Do we have anything here? Except flies. I hope it's from the dung, not some... What? What has happened here? Are you okay? What is going on?
Oh, there. Tranquilo.
Okay, let's feed the horse. If we can.
Shit.
Feed it and give it water. Excrement.
How long have you been here like this?
That is a good question. Water and food. Water and food. There is faucet. Hopefully it works. Take it easy, horsey.
El gusto es mío.
Now we need to get something to eat. Carrots, maybe? If they are in good shape. Can I take more than one? No, I can drop it. Do you want anything else I can give? Do we... What is... There are tools over here, I have to check those. What do we have here? It seems like the carrots are the only one I can give at this point. So we go with the carrots then.
Despacio.
Well, to be honest, that was only a one carrot.
No running for now. Get your strength back. No running for now. Get your strength back.
Okay. Fortunately, we could help the horse at least for now. Let's check the tools. Anything missing? I guess not. So let's go up. Okay. Use saddles. What else? I really can't see anything. Whoa, what do we have here? Workbench. Chainsaw. Okay. Could we use that? And there's a photograph. Okay. Anything else? No. Let's check the photo.
Adam, care to tell me why my assistant graduated with blue hair?
Ah, no. I told my Aunt Esther to get rid of that picture. I made a bet with Marcelo. If I graduated before he finished his thesis, I had to do it. Where'd you find it?
I'll tell you later.
Okay, I really have a bad feeling about this. The horse hasn't been fed for a while. Nobody's answering my calls. Phone cable is off. Oh, I was going to check the... Can I... Apparently I can't just leave. Is that a hand? No, it's a glove. Yeah, I see what you did there. So... That's it. Anything else? Okay. I guess there's nothing here except... Let's move up. They have a wagon. Well, yeah, I guess they could use that lift there, but still, why? Am I going to find anything up here? Maybe a body? Maybe somebody who's trying to attack me? Looks empty at least here. There are some hot spots. We can get to roof and we will get to roof, but before that we have a window.
Adam?
Hold on, Nick. Sorry, I'm back. Everything okay?
The big tree. In the field behind the barn. Who's under it?
Cousin Leonard. I never met him. What was it? 50 years ago? He was stillborn. My aunt almost died. They had to remove her uterus or ovaries or something. Nick? You still there?
Sounds terrible. Thanks, man. I'll see you at the station.
Well, right. The handle is a little bit off from the window. Anyways, was there something else over here? Oh, it was just lighting. And let's go to the roof. This is one tall building. Hopefully our dear sheriff doesn't suffer from vertigo. I wouldn't go there. A glove. Another glove. We have two gloves. But where's the person who wore the gloves? Actually, I can't even move, so... I was supposed to find the gloves? What does it all mean? So... We are done here? Can I check the glove any closer now? I'm guessing I can't? No. Had I known that after the eating and reviewing the notes, we skipped to another character, I could have ended the episode on this, but it seemed like a good place to end because I was certain that it would load from there. And to be honest, it would be... It's hard to say when you're playing for the first time what happens when.
No running for now. Get your strength back.
Okay, nothing new. So...
Nick, you there? Just a reminder, you got a meeting with the mayor in half an hour.
Oh, no.
Hey, I can hear Frankie Lane. How is he?
I don't think your uncle's taking very good care of him.
Seriously? The old man is really losing it. You'll be here on time, right?
You better fill in for me, all right?
Again? Sneaky bastard.
To be honest, there might be a situation that I'm not able to leave. I'm trying to... So the glove was on this side. I can't go over these. No bodies, at least I can see. So I don't... we can check the car, I think. Well, we check the car first and then we go inside the house. And see what we can find out. Pick up. Key. Fishing gear.
Madam, were you planning on fishing with your uncle anytime soon?
No. Why? He hasn't invited me since I told him about Marcello.
No reason. Just curious.
It's probably for the best, to be honest.
You're quite indifferent about what I'm questioning about your uncle and aunt. Okay, the keys are in ignition. So... nothing else. Okay. The front. Door, but what? The wild theory. Okay, I have a few wild theories. Well, not really, but soonish. I guess we go inside. Right. Keep searching outside. Ring again. Open. I try to keep searching outside once more. I want to check the side. If I can... here I can't go. Oh!
Adam, your Uncle Samuel doesn't take care of the whole ranch by himself, does he?
Well, from what my aunt says, it's been hard to find anyone willing to work with him. Which doesn't surprise me.
Okay, so... and you honestly don't report about the telephone line? There's no reason to ring the bell anymore, so I think we just try to go in. And let's open. and it's locked, I guess. Or is it? Why do I have to make the choice again? Enter. So it's the ground floor of the house. Okay. Whoa. No, that's not good. That was quite huge stutter there. I don't know. Well, not stutter. Freezing. Okay. Half-eaten breakfast. Moldy. So somebody came on morning. And there's something over there. Money.
Well, at least they didn't rob you.
That is true, so... happened. Glasses on the balcony. No idea if there's actually is going to be some action in this game. Maybe some quick time events, probably. Photograph, let's check that. Grandma's apple pie. Anything else? No, I don't think there are. So... grandfather clock. Old TV. Phone. Not really. Is that water dripping from the faucet? Cocks on the wall or roosters. Don't forget to flush. I can't see if it's already flushed, but I hope so. Flush it. Best seat in the house. Okay. At least time to time. Embroidery. Our little angel. Save us from heaven. Our little angel save us from heaven, I guess. Or heave. And nothing out of the ordinary, at least. Okay. I have to be ready for quick time events. Okay. Les Miserables and The Secret Garden. Both of the books are on Ted Miller's house also, but there, well, we can't make any assumption from there. Somebody really liked birds. Oh, there's a pig also. Or is it a... Yes, it's a pig. I was thinking, is it a cow, maybe, but... yeah, it's a pig. But yeah, let's... Ooh, those are long legs on the bird. I think on a hen. What's up over the TV? V88 Mini 4K. 4K on a CRT TV, okay. Not judging. Bathroom door, let's open it. I have to say, nice scar on the face. Okay. Somehow I felt like it's going to be something else than a human. No, don't leave from the bathroom, I want to check the rest of it. I'm coming, mother. Oh! What's in the wardrobe? Let's open the other door also. Did I hear something? A suitcase. Why did you check the suitcase? That was weird. And to be honest, why are you not reporting this? Before we continue, I want to check basement. Well, basement is the last one I go. Well, not last one, but not at least yet. So I checked everything in here except that suitcase, which we are not able to check. What about this photo? Okay, there's the Ed Miller. Okay, so they went fishing together. Okay, those sounds when they are sometimes very loud, they give me the... Wait, what? Why there is a baby grip? A giraffe? Fox? Have they been keeping the room as a shrine? Okay, so I'm guessing we don't need to... Why did you slam the door? Jeez. So... The only thing we have to check now is the basement. Do not like. That's not a good thing. I am guessing we will find something horrible in here. Wait a minute. Because it seems like, well, the idea that we are smelling something rotting or decomposing.
Nick, the mayor just left. Fill you in? Nick? Everything all right?
I'm busy. I'll let you know later.
And Adam is not at all suspicious what's happening here. Do I want to go there or... This is always my problem. I want to see everything. Oh no. What's inside the blanket? Under the blanket, I mean. Or inside. Under. Let's see. You can't be serious. Oh, game. That's unfair. Just when she almost dozed off.
Oh. Okay, the alarm will ring in 10 minutes.
Oh. But I think this is the perfect end. Place to end this episode. I know it's nothing really didn't happen, but I'm guessing this is the game that you, well, it's more about the journey and the atmosphere than excitement and happenings. I try to keep them, well, I really haven't planned how I keep these chapters, but I think it's good to end the chapter now that we have been with the police and start with fresh with the doctor. So anyways, I hope you enjoyed this episode and I will see you next time. Until then, goodbye.